It's the most wonderful time of the year, but also can be the most stressful, and that's okay. We can have duality here. It can be a great time, we can have a lot of fun, but there can be stress and anxiety associated with it. That's why I've got this yin yoga for the holidays all ready to go for you. So when you're ready, grab a block or two if you have them. They're not completely necessary. I'm keeping today simple for you guys. When you're ready, I'll see you on the mat. We'll start today by grounding in child's pose. So come to have your big toes touch, separate your knees about mat width distance apart, and allow your sit bones to relax towards your heels. If they don't touch, that's okay, it's normal, we'll make do. From here, you can either walk your arms out and melt your chest and forehead to the ground, or you may find it more relaxing and grounding to place a block underneath your forehead and rest your forehead. Wherever you're at, forehead on the mat or not, I encourage you to bend into your elbows to create a diamond-like shape with your arms. This will help you to relax in the shoulders. Bring ease into the body. Slow your breath down by inhaling for three and exhaling for three. Inhale and exhale. Use this breath, filling your belly, and then releasing through your belly as your tool to take you through this practice. It's a tool that you can use off of the mat to find calm in moments of stress. But for now, we're focused on melting our bodies into the ground, the support beneath us. Notice if you're holding any tension in your shoulders. Can you feel your shoulder blades glide down your spine and melt heavy towards the mat? Lengthen into the back of your neck as you create space in your spine. Five more breaths here. Lift your head off the mat. Walk your hands towards your knees. Knees and legs can come together. Take a moment to bring your hand to your chest, your other hand to your belly. Take a deep inhale in. Exhale, sigh it out. Close your eyes and notice the sensations from just one pose. How may have shifted the energy in your body already. together. We'll walk forward all the way so that you come to lie on your belly. Extend your legs out long behind you. Elbows come underneath shoulders as your fingertips point towards the top of your mat. Take a moment to wiggle on your hip flexors so you can find length in your legs here. Fingers spread wide, push into your palms and forearms, and then gently pull back. Feel your chest open towards the front of your mat. Inhale, flex into your glutes. Legs may rise off the mat. Exhale, release. Notice how much you might have been holding there. Allow your neck to come to neutral, looking just off the top of your mat. And we'll take 5 breaths here in Sphinx. Keep your upper body just as it is. Bend into your right leg. We'll move into half frog here with a Sphinx upper body. And with your right leg, make sure it's at a 90-degree angle. So your knee is straight out from your hip, and then your ankle is straight down from your knee. You can flex into your foot here for a moment. But on an exhale, release. Allow this leg, this right hip, to become heavy. To let go, soften even through the sole of your foot. And notice how the sensation in your lower back changes with one leg up. Know that at any time, if this sensation in Sphinx in your upper body becomes like too much and you want to chill out, you can always stack your palms over one another, elbows out to either side, and forehead may come to relax. Otherwise, you can stay in Sphinx if this feels comfortable to you. Extend your right leg out long behind you. Close your eyes down. Feel the difference from right leg and hip to left. Together, we'll bend into left leg. Bring your left leg into half frog now. Maybe you flex through the sole of the foot. Notice what the activation feels like, and on an exhale, release. Sometimes it takes that moment of activation to understand what it feels like when the muscles are turned on versus not. Find stillness and softness here in your glutes. Maybe even close down your eyes. Extend your left leg long behind you. Take notice of the difference once again. This time we'll all stack our palms, elbows out to either side. Relax your forehead onto your hands. Come to stack or to bring your hands underneath your shoulders. Push yourself up onto all fours. Maybe a few rounds of cat-cow here. Feel nice for your body, inviting a little bit of chi, some energy back in after that long hold. Rocking, any movement is always invited. Come to a neutral spine. Step your right foot to the outside of your right hand. You may want to wiggle your left knee back or even fold over your mat so that your left knee is padded. Bring your hands underneath your shoulders so that you can lunge forward. Melt your left hip flexor towards the ground. Right toes may even come off the mat. Might feel nicer to point your foot out on an angle, give yourself a bit more space into your right hip. Here's where you may want some blocks. You can always bring the ground a little bit closer to you. Place your hands on the blocks. This is not always about flexibility, but sometimes comfort as well. So please use the blocks if you're feeling like they may assist you in finding more peace today. Allow your shoulder blades to glide down your spine as you settle into stillness here. Dragon pose can be a little bit scary, like how it sounds, but it doesn't have to be. This pose is often about finding the comfort in the discomfort. Much like we need to find the comfort in the stress sometimes. Though it's not always what we want or what we need. Periods of stress come and go, just like discomfort comes and goes. Use your breath here as the tool to help guide you through. An option to stay just as you are, or your elbows may come down onto blocks or the ground. We'll take five more deep breaths here. Remember those belly breaths. Inhale to expand. Exhale to release, deflate. Exhale, bring your hands back to the mat if they're not already. You can step your right foot back. Maybe you do a toe heel thing. Be gentle with yourself. Maybe you come to all fours for some cat-cows. Perhaps downward dog is calling you. You might tuck your toes, lift your sit bones up towards the sky. You can always pedal out your legs, walk your dog. I'm simply here as a guide. Sometimes you have to tap into, not sometimes, all the time, what you need. We'll meet back on all fours. This time, left foot steps to the outside of your left hand. Wiggle your right knee back. Find padding if you'd like. And then hands underneath shoulders. Here on this side too, play around with where you would like your left foot placed. I always like to angle mine outwards for extra space in my hip. And though I can reach the ground, I find blocks give a lot more length into my spine and actually make this pose more comfortable. But you do what works for you today. I invite you to close down your eyes here and to send your breath to your right hip flexor. Notice how on each exhale, as you focus your breath to this area, does it help the muscles to soften, to release and let go? Or do you continue to hold tension there? How can you help that area relax further? Release through your jaw and soften the area of your forehead around your eyes. No tension in your face. Just because one area is trying to find comfort doesn't mean we need to hold tension in others. Option to come down onto your elbows or stay on your hands. We have five more breaths here. And on an exhale, help your upper body back up. Wiggle left foot back behind you. Find stillness on all fours, cat cows, or downward facing dog. Wherever you're at, take a deep inhale through the nose. Stick your tongue out, breathe out. Once more, deep inhale. Tongue sticks out. We'll meet back on all fours, then come to sit on your sit bones. You may choose to use your blocks here or come to rest on your hands, so I recommend having them close by. If you're quite tight in the backs of your legs or have knee injuries, you can always use the blocks underneath your knees as well. Inhale, sit with a long spine, sit bones grounded to the mat, crown of head reaches in opposite direction. Soften through your feet and then begin to allow your upper body to curl forward. Not too worried about keeping the spine straight here. Think more of a surrender. For support, you may want to place a block underneath your forehead. Or if you don't have blocks, you can always create fists with your hands.
Perhaps your forehead reaches your hands. Let your upper body feel heavy. Let it guide itself closer towards the ground. And as it needs space, you can release yourself. Release some support so that you may move closer. Three more deep breaths here.
Inhale, push into your hands, walk your hands back towards your legs. Take a moment here, allow the energy to rush back down into your body. Bring your hands underneath your legs. Use them to help bring your legs together. Give yourself a nice big hug here.
Allow your chin to fall heavy towards your chest.
Inhale your head back up and then allow yourself to come to lay on the mat on your back. As we move into Shavasana, you may want to place your blocks underneath your knees. Otherwise, we'll all come to lay flat on our backs, your arms out far from your sides. Take up space. Allow whatever stress and anxiety that you're holding in your body to release every tiny bit as you expand your body. Take a deep inhale through your nose. Sigh it out. Once more, deep inhale. Be as loud as you'd like. Be completely supported by the ground beneath you. And find stillness here for our final few breaths. gently begin to wiggle your fingers and your toes. Invite movement into your wrists and ankles. On a deep inhale, reach your hands above your head, your legs come together. Exhale to release. Hug your knees towards your chest one at a time and roll to either side into fetal position.
Spend as much time here as you'd like. Whenever you're ready, begin to push yourself up.
And we'll meet in a comfortable seat with our hands in prayer. Bow your forehead so your third eye meets your fingertips.
And thank yourself for showing up on the mat today, for doing this act of self-love for your mind, body, and your soul.
Bring your head back up. May you feel kind words. May you speak kind words. May you think kind words. Together, we'll bow forward and say thank you. I hope you are ready to take on the rest of your day and have released some of that icky energy. My name's Taylor. I hope to see you again soon. Have a fabulous rest of your day and holiday season. Don't forget, I release a new video every Thursday, so hit that subscribe button and I'll see you again soon.